So we want to enhance the wrapped Floer theory. Let's just say. Using some sort of data which lives on the boundary of our Liouville domain. And the boundary, I'm going to call it x, where x is a Liouville domain. Is this a good size, by the way? OK. Can I use what? Big chalk, yes. Is this the white one? Yes. OK. All right, so I want to enhance wrapped Floer theory using some kind of data in the boundary. This is mirror, or at least we should imagine that it's mirror, to some kind of compactification data for x dual, or x mirror. I'm not going to discuss that until the end, but that's what we're supposed to have in the back of our mind.
Partial.
Yes, absolutely, partial compactification. I should move this to the top immediately. Okay. So let me just immediately define what this data is going to be. The definition, a stop, which I'm going to write sigma in. A stop is going to be something which lives in the boundary of x, and I'm going to call it a stop in x. Is a hypersurface with boundary such that sigma is itself a Liouville domain. So that means sigma with the Liouville one form on x, that's an x restricted to sigma, is a Liouville domain. That's what a stop is. And what are the motivating examples of this sort of thing? So the first thing, well, locally, this means that it's something which looks like the page of an adapted open book, if you know what an open book is. If not, I'll give you several more examples. So. Boundary of x. Is this boundary of x readable over there? OK, great. So the first example is this contact thing, the page of an open book. And in a sense, a generalization. So many open books come from Lefschetz vibrations. And if you have a Lefschetz vibration or a Landau-Ginzburg model, then we can so if we have some Landau-Ginzburg model W, we can take the preimage of a generic point, which we should imagine is a generic point near infinity. Okay, so what does that look like? I have kind of x, and I map it to c. And I have some generic point, and it has some fiber. And what I do with this is I project it along the Liouville vector field to the boundary of x. And that gives us, well, this was a Liouville divisor, essentially, and we project it, and we continue getting, in reasonable cases, a Liouville hypersurface. Okay. So that's two ways of doing it. There's another type of thing we can do. So if you prefer Lagrangian skeleton Legendrians to superpotentials, you can take a smooth Legendrian L in the boundary, and we can thicken this in the contact direction. So what does that mean? That means L has a standard neighborhood modeled on its one-jet bundle. And inside the one-jet bundle, we have the cotangent bundle. And the cotangent bundle is a Liouville hypersurface of the one-jet bundle. And we can just kind of transfer that over using the standard neighborhood. Modeled on T star L in J1L. Okay. And finally, what's expected is that this works with singular, or at least reasonable singular Legendrians as well. With singular L, and in particular, it works for the boundary, or it's expected to work for the boundary of a Legendrian, of Lagrangian skeleton. Of X. All right. So these kind of existing structures which are mirror to compactifications or partial compactifications of the mirror all kind of at least want to give rise to a stop. Okay. Any questions on what a stop is? Yeah.
Well, the base of everything has a skeleton, then somehow at least less thing would be the general case.
Yeah. If you have the cotangent bundle of a manifold with boundary, then the boundary of that manifold will be the boundary of your Lagrangian skeleton. If you have it depends what your skeleton is, but if you take the zero section as your skeleton, then this will be empty unless the manifold has boundary.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. Then what that's going to mean is that we have essentially no data on the boundary, and we're going to recover ordinary wrapped Floer theory. Okay. So next I should say, how do we use this to produce some sort of Floer theory? So I'm going to start with the idea again. With stops. And so essentially, we want to pick Rabe dynamics which are adapted to the stop. So we're going to pick a Rabe vector field. Adapted to sigma, which means so it's still associated to a contact form which makes sigma symplectic. Sigma still but now the Rabe is parallel or tangent to the boundary. Okay. And what this does is that all trajectories are either going to live in the boundary of sigma, or they're going to have some finite positive intersection number with sigma. Let's just write this on the following board. Okay. So this means all trajectories either in sigma in the boundary of sigma, or have some intersection number n sigma, some fixed non-negative integer. Okay, and the partially wrapped just means n sigma equals 0. So we consider only those trajectories which don't live in the boundary of sigma and don't even touch sigma at all. All right. So let me say now more accurately what this means. And I'm going to do that. It's going to be slightly strange symplectic pictures. But by drawing these pictures, we'll then be able to see precisely what changed with this Rabe vector field when we made everything adapted to the stop. So we're going to use a local model. F hat cross H in, or sorry, I'm calling it X, X hat. So X was some Liouville domain. X hat is its completion, which just means we've added a symplectization in to turn the Liouville vector field into a complete vector field. F is some fiber, I'm thinking of it as the fiber of sigma. So F is essentially sigma not as an embedded hypersurface, but as an abstract Liouville domain on its own. And H is the interesting thing. This is some large half space. And what does that mean? Well, let me draw it. I have the half space is going to be everything to the is going to be this. This is some half space in the standard Liouville C. So the Liouville vector field kind of points out from the origin. How is this embedded in X hat? Well, I have the boundary of X. And so I want this to be a thing which lives near the boundary as a proper codimension zero embedding. Is the proper codimension zero embedding. And where does what does this have to do with sigma? Well, let me draw that. I think red was distinct as a color. Let's find out. So I have the central fiber, F, which I'm going to soon start calling F0. But if I take this spike, or kind of this part of a spike coming out from F0 to the boundary, that's a hypersurface in X hat, again, a hypersurface with boundary, then the intersection of this thing with the boundary of X is sigma again. And it's sigma kind of with a Liouville vector field, or with a contact one-form, or Rabe vector field, which is appropriately adapted. And I'm just going to want to extend that to explain how we're going to define the Floer theory. But this thing is OK. Any questions there? F hat is sigma no longer thought of there is the completion of sigma, no longer thought of as an embedded thing, just as an abstract Liouville domain of dimension 2 lower. So I should perhaps say F sigma. So it's, I'm going to call this the fiber of sigma, because I'm usually mentally using this local model, rather than just thinking of sigma as being an embedded hypersurface. Yeah, that's the Liouville vector field. Gluing what is the we have x living over here on the interior, and then we have the boundary of x, and near the boundary we've constructed this local model.
So I guess this is what is confusing to me is that it seems to me that if x is over here, the Liouville vector field that needs to be flowing out of x at the boundary of x.
So it really is about how I draw the boundary. Kind of here it's flowing out, and it's mostly flowing out. And these should really be curved relative to one another. So we can think of this H as kind of having a curved embedding.
Oh, I see.
The boundary of X is the dotted thing. The boundary of H, so this is the boundary of H. Let's put an actual boundary there.
So let me rephrase my question. How's the boundary of H sit?
It's just some... It's that's part of the data of this local model. It looks like this. Okay.
So the not dotted line is boundary of H cross F.
Yes, absolutely. Sorry. Boundary of H cross F hat cross boundary of H. I hear something? Another question? Okay. So here's this local model. For the most part, I'm just going to draw a picture of H or something slightly bigger, but it is relevant how it sits in X. Okay, so in this local model, we have a central fiber. F0, and we want to choose H and J fixing F0, which just means that J fixing F0 means that F0 is an almost complex submanifold. H fixing F0 means that the Hamiltonian vector field of H is tangent to X0. And the result of this is that we're going to get some positivity of intersections. This is not important for the non-symplectic geometers. Okay. And what does this do? So now the equivalent of this separation of trajectories that we had is that we're going to get filtrations. So in the open string case, we're going to get a filtration and this filtration I'm writing CW sigma. This, by definition, is the trajectories. So because I'm open string, I shouldn't be allowing the Lagrangians, the boundary conditions, to touch the central fiber. And then the filtration is just by crossing number with this red spike. Filtration by non-negative integers. There's a CW0 in CW1 and all of this sits inside the wrapped cochain complex of whatever Lagrangians. And in the closed string case, more complicated. Essentially, there's just one extra term that sits between 0 and 1 associated to orbits which live in the central fiber. But in some situations, there are additional pieces of the filtration that aren't visible here. So I don't really want to write it down. Okay. So let me use this and just quickly define partially wrapped Foucaille categories, and then I'll start drawing kind of what how you should think of all of this. The partially wrapped. No, let's just do this on the next board. Which is written W sigma of x is it's an A-infinity category with objects. These are going to be exact Lagrangians with Legendrian boundary, so same as objects of the wrapped Foucaille category, and we just want these objects to avoid sigma. L with Legendrian boundary avoiding sigma. And then the morphisms star of L0, L1 is just this CW sigma. Okay. All right. So that's the partially wrapped Foucaille category. And how does it look? So now I'm going to start drawing some vector fields so we can see how this ought to be related to other things. Any questions in the meantime?
So your rotation is CW sigma doesn't equal that filtration equals the 0 part.
It's the 0 part. So how does this look? So let me go back to that local model. The wrapping vector field goes from, so if we ignore any compatibility with sigma, the wrapping vector field, so here's our half space, and I'm really drawing what happens far out in the fiber, or I'm drawing the portion, the base portion of what happens far out in the fiber. So the wrapping vector field kind of, it just kind of wraps in the positive direction. If we had the boundary of M, this would be parallel to the boundary, or the boundary of X, sorry, this is just parallel to the boundary of X. And what happens to it? It goes to something more interesting. I'm going to put this extra thing here because now I need to modify the vector field. So now this vector field needs to circle around this origin. And it's going to do that by introducing a saddle point. Is the vector field visible? I probably should have used other colors for these special points. It's good? Okay. All right, so this is the new vector field that we have. So if we're interested in partially wrapped, well, we throw out everything that comes into this region, right? Because any trajectory in this region is going to have to cross this spike. So nothing here contributes. But by changing the vector field, we've introduced a bunch of new stuff, which comes very close to this saddle fiber. And in doing so, it takes some trajectory in the saddle fiber before exiting and continuing on its way. So over here, we have what essentially looks like the standard Rabe dynamics of x. And over here, whenever we get close, we're allowed to do kind of very interesting Rabe dynamics in the stop or on the fiber. Changes. Let's say changes. So we started with, and what I mean is, before we tried to partially wrap, we had this as a wrapping vector field. And after we tried to partially wrap, we have this as a vector field. Yeah? What is supposed to? So for partially wrapped, nothing is allowed to intersect this thing. Not L, not the generators, just nothing. Nothing is allowed to intersect this.
So this was sticking out from some disorder. You wouldn't have the fiber of the cotangent bundle.
You wouldn't have the fiber of the cotangent bundle. The stop, this fiber, is the cotangent bundle of the Legendrian. Is that?
Right. And then if you sort of multiply it by R.
Yeah. We wouldn't have Lagrangians that end on here, but we can have if we have a Lagrangian in here, we can have kind of some filling of it that goes over here, or we can have a filling that goes over here. So, kind of, if this is the cotangent bundle of some Legendrian, it's very easy to take a Lagrangian that would have ended here and push it to one side or other. Is that okay? Okay. So let me say what this is expected to look like. Oh, did I just ignore? Yeah. All right, great. Let's. Yes. Something like that. I think it's supposed to correspond to. So as we increase this, we get things that live kind of more and more on the complement of the divisor. So they're allowed kind of more and more severe poles along the divisor. Okay. So what do we expect this to look like? So expectations. And I don't think any of these is rigorously proven, but several of them are being worked on by various groups of people. The first one is going to be if you have a stop associated to a superpotential, then this thing should be equivalent to the Foucaultcidal category of that superpotential. And the reason for this is, well, yes, there was all this extra stuff that we added, but that was far out in the fiber. So thimbles are compact in the fiber of a superpotential. And so they don't really see any of this new stuff they kind of just immediately get stuck on this stop. So we expect that the partially wrapped agrees with the Foucaultcidal. And this should, I mean, everything I up to split closures. I don't want to talk about which categories have more objects than which ones. Just you should imagine that everything I write has a 12 pi in front of it. In the Legendrian case, we have W sigma, where L was a Legendrian of X. This should agree with the Legendrian DGA. And I'm going to be a little bit vague about what this means, but we want a Legendrian DGA of L with coefficients in chains on the loop space of L, the base loop space, probably minus star. And when I this brackets, I mean non-central coefficients. So these coefficients don't actually commute, but somehow I want to think of this DGA as an algebra over this DGA.
This is assuming that x itself is zero.
Yes. It's actually, I think it's just, it's assuming that, or that the dimension is high enough that kind of the skeleton of x doesn't interact with holomorphic curves near the boundary. Sorry. Yes. This is for yes, this is if you're right, absolutely. If yes. This is something that we should really be imagining applying to situations where X is a ball and we have some Legendrian in a sphere. Yeah. Sorry, absolutely right. And probably kind of. I mean, so this. So if W of X is zero, this is going to be generated by one object, and I'll tell you that shortly. That's essentially the next thing I wanted to get to once I gave these expectations. But this will be generated when W of X is zero. This will be generated by one object, or in general, one object for each component of L. And endomorphisms of that object should agree with the DGA. Let me just give the final one. How's time? Yeah. So finally, W sigma lambda. So if we had some Lagrangian skeleton of X, this should agree with. And I should point out this is essentially the situation that Lenny was talking about. When there's a Lagrangian skeleton, we expect this to agree with Nadler's wrapped microlocal sheaves of X. I switched from M to X for a reason that will not matter until the last 5 minutes, but I did. Lambda is a Lagrangian skeleton for X. Sigma is the stop associated to the boundary of the Lagrangian skeleton. If it doesn't have boundary, then this is just the wrapped Foucault category. And this is a case of the wrapped microlocal sheaf category. OK. Let's see. do this, and then I want to push that up. This is going to be a disaster. No, I'm stuck. Okay, let's put this thing down. Okay, so. Do I still have it somewhere? No, I erased it. The stop associated the so if you have a if the boundary is smooth,
no, but if it isn't.
If the boundary is not smooth, then you need to check that there is a thickening, but you would try to thicken in the same way.
So we don't know it exists.
We don't know it exists in general. In some cases, we can construct it. I did not claim that it exists in general. I stated expectations. I'm not claiming any of these as theorems.
Maybe the expectation is the thing on the left-hand side exists and equals things.
Yeah. So for general singular Legendrians, we don't actually expect to be able to thicken. There's a smooth obstruction to thickening. If lambda is, say, arboreal, then we expect to be able to thicken. And then we expect those to agree. Okay. How can we say anything about these categories? So kind of one piece of structure that we always have is that there exists an inclusion functor. I sigma from the wrapped Foucault category of the fiber of sigma. To the partially wrapped Foucault category of X. And what does it do? In this picture, let me actually grab the color. In this picture, we can put this curve gamma in the base, in kind of if we had extended this vibration a little bit farther, we can put this curve gamma. And roughly speaking, this inclusion takes a object of the fiber, so it takes a Lagrangian in the fiber, and it crosses it or parallel transports it over this arc. And this is essentially the Orlov functor. Okay, so let me actually state a theorem. If, under a technical assumption that I won't precisely define, but I'll give you examples, if sigma is strongly non-degenerate, then what do I want to say? Then the then the map from Coker of I sigma to W of M is fully faithful. Yes, M is X. Thank you. So I guess one should say that all of these objects map to zero in the fully wrapped Foucault category, because once we get rid of the stop, we can just displace the Lagrangian. Everything in the image of this is a displaceable Lagrangian. It's a zero object of the wrapped Foucault category. So there is an induced map from the co-kernel of this Orlov functor, and the theorem says that that's fully faithful under some assumption. Okay.
Can you give us an example of when sigma is or is not?
That's exactly what I was about to do. No. Thank you for asking. I'll give you two examples and one. Oh, whoops, wait. I need to get that board back. This is fun. Okay. So, yeah. So strong non-degeneracy is some generalization of non-degeneracy due to Ganatra, or, well, first written by Abu Zaid, but defined as the word non-degenerate by Ganatra. So examples, the following are strongly degenerate. So first, any open surface. Surfaces. And I guess I should say other than the disk. And this is something you can check by hand. So any time x is four-dimensional, then sigma is two-dimensional, and it's strongly non-degenerate. Any cotangent bundle? And this is essentially due to Abu Zaid. And kind of jointly generalizing these, we expect, or at least I expect, and I think others do too, that Weinstein domains or at least those admitting nice skeleta, which is expected to be all of them, Weinstein domains admitting a skeleta, and this is expected. Well, the expectation is due to work of Ganatra. Pardon. Okay. So these are all things that we expect to be strongly non-degenerate. It's a condition on F sigma. Sure, I can say. I'm going to probably continue abusing notation there, but yeah.
In these cases, I mean, these three conditions you've written, those are all examples of X, right?
No, these are all examples of F. Well, they're examples of Liouville domains, and I care about the fiber being strongly non-degenerate as a Liouville domain. I care less about X being strongly non-degenerate. For this theorem. Well, in other situations, I might want X to be strongly non-degenerate, or at least I might want X to be non-degenerate, because that's situations where we can hope to understand things at the moment. So to answer Paul's question about how these things match, if we have a Legendrian, then the fiber is a cotangent bundle. It's generated by a single object. We map that object forward using this Orloff functor and the endomorphisms of the image object are expected to agree with the DGA. Okay. Other questions about this picture? Okay. So let me state. Yeah. I think we expect that any Weinstein domain is strongly non-degenerate. I don't know about things that aren't Weinstein domains. So let me give a strengthening of this theorem in progress. So strength. This I'm going to give the proof, or well, I'm going to give the version that I know. There's also a better version in progress due to, again, Ganatra Pardon Shende. And I'll state it, the version again that I know. Let's say we have Liouville domains with stops, M1, sigma 1, M2, sigma 2, have an isomorphism of fibers, F sigma 1, F sigma 2, which I'm just going to define to be F. And I'm going to identify them under this isomorphism. And F is strongly non-degenerate. Then we get a more complicated version of these functors. We can form some gluing M, which is a boundary fiber sum. So sigma 1 is some hypersurface of the boundary, sigma 2 is some hypersurface of the boundary, and we have an isomorphism between them, a Liouville isomorphism. And so we can connect some along that boundary fiber. And I'm going to call that M. So this is M1 glued to M2 along sigma 1 and sigma 2. So the statement is, I lost things. Sigma is a thing which is embedded in the boundary. F is just an abstract Liouville domain. Then there's a map. There's a map of diagrams. So I have these inclusion functors to sigma 1 of, I should have been calling these x's, whatever. I have sigma 2 to w sigma 2 of m. And these, in fact, admit kind of similar inclusion maps to w sigma. Well, I'm going to ignore the fact that there might be leftover stops. So this M does not have sigma 1 or sigma 2 as stops, but it might have more stops. I'm going to suppress that from the notation. W of M. So we have this thing, and this thing is a pushout square. Uh, which means in principle, though generally not in practice, we can compute the wrapped Foucault category of M from this data on the left.
You mean M1 and
M2? Oh, yes, M1, M2. And actually, for the way I stated it, I should really require that everything is strongly non-degenerate. If all I know is that the fiber is strongly non-degenerate, then there's a map from the pushout to here, and that's fully faithful. But if not everything is known to be strongly non-degenerate, then there isn't a generation statement that I know how to make. If everything is strongly non-degenerate, then this is a pushout square. Okay. So I'd like to spend the last 10 minutes, or the last 8 minutes, to give an example of all of this, which is kind of a fun example. We'll move some things up. So the example is going to be V-turbo functoriality. And it's going to be how we can then use this description of V-turbo functoriality to get kind of interesting maps between Foucault categories of or Foucault categories associated to Landau-Ginzburg models that are hard to see in the picture with thimbles, that are hard to see in other ways. So first, let me say what V-turbo functoriality is. So given a codimension zero embedding of Liouville domains, M in and M, we get V-turbo transfer maps on wrapped Floer theory. So the simplest, the first one due to V-turbo is from the symplectic cohomology of M to the symplectic cohomology of M in. And this is due to V-turbo. There's an enhancement due to Krog. And on open strings, we have a map on wrapped Foucault categories, or at least a partially defined map on wrapped Foucault categories. We'll need to change it a little bit to make it globally defined. And this is due to Abu Zaid and Seidel. There's a stop way of seeing these. There's a stoppy way of seeing this map on wrapped Floer theory, and it involves kind of choosing careful stops in a fairly simple manifold. So I want to consider M across a disk, and I'm just drawing the disk here. And I'm going to put two stops. One stop is going to be just M cross a point. And one stop is going to be M in. Remember, a stop is just some hypersurface of the boundary. And well, if M is a Liouville hypersurface of the boundary and Mn is a Liouville thing inside M, then this is also a Liouville hypersurface of the boundary. And this is going to give us these inclusion functors, Im and Imn. All right, so we can do a computation and I'm just going to give the result of computation. And it's that I am in. This goes again from the wrapped Foucault category of Mn to the partially wrapped Foucault category of M cross D with the given stops is fully faithful. And that's with no assumptions. This functor is fully faithful. So what this means, if Mn is strongly non-degenerate, then the inclusion functor, toi pi, the inclusion functor after taking split closures is an equivalence. Is a quasi-equivalence. And what this means is we can recover the V-turbo functor, can recover this map defined. Let me rewrite that. Twa pi of I am in. So I have this inclusion functor here. It takes a Lagrangian in M in, transports it over that arc. This map is fully faithful, because if any kind of morphism that doesn't live right here would end up having to cross M because M is bigger than M in. And so it's fully faithful. And if M in is strongly non-degenerate, that means, we quotient by this and we get zero, which means the image of this generated, or split generated. So that tells us that on twa pi, it's a quasi-equivalence. Okay, and what does this do? This means that we can recover the V-turbo functor. The V-turbo transfer functor, not the functor from the symplectic category to Foucault, but the functor on Foucault categories. And it's the inverse of this. Composed with the inclusion from M. So I take a Lagrangian in M, I put it in, and then I see how it's built out of things in Mn. Okay. So what can we do with this to say something about mirror symmetry in the last minute or so? Application. If W0 is a subpolynomial, which I won't write the definition of, but I'll say if you have some polynomial W, that's some sum of monomials, and W0 is a sum of some of those monomials, but not all of them. Okay? So this is mirror to a divisor, which is some union of irreducibles. And this thing is D minus some smaller union. Smaller. So this corresponds to kind of, if I can move from W to W0, that corresponds to removing some but not all of the irreducible components of the anti-canonical divisor. All right, so if this is the case, then there's a Liouville embedding W0 inverse of point into W inverse of point. So this lets us draw a picture. What this does is it lets us decompose. We can decompose the partially wrapped Foucault category associated to W0 as a gluing. So what does this look like? This looks like we have X. We have M in, which is W0 inverse of point. And this looks like a gluing where we have X, we have W inverse of point, which is M. And then we glue this to exactly this thing that we looked at over here. So we can put an M in over there. And what this means is that there's a map from from the category associated to M, so the category associated to W, sigma W of X, to partially wrapped associated sigma W0 of X. This is a map that I don't know how to see in terms of thimbles. Yes, Paul? You know how to see it. Is it?
Well, Gabe Kerr was here, I could ask him, but I think
okay. Okay, so this perhaps does have actually a very simple description in terms of thimbles that I didn't know about. Okay. So there's one final thing to say about this map, which is that if we believe the stronger theorem, and we believe that these fibers are going to tend to be strongly non-degenerate, because in the cases we care about, they're Weinstein domains, then we can actually describe this map explicitly. So let me grab this button, one more board. I'll just say in words because I'm out of time. This map is given by a pushout of the kind of inclusion functor of the divisors that now I'm just confused. So we have this map M. So we have the inclusion of the anticanonical divisor. That's what the map IM corresponds to. We have kind of the restriction to the complement of some component, which is mirror to the V-turbo thing. And this map is precisely a pushout of the inclusion of M and the restriction of M to M in. All right, I'll stop at this point.